Hi everyone, myself Priyanka, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, Christ College, Autonomous, Irinalakuda. We are moving with our lectures in Principles of Compilers. So we are in the topic of the Principles of Compiler, that is Intermediate Code Generation. So we are moving to the next topic in the Intermediate Code Generation, that is TYPE, that is data types, how the data handling is done by the compilers. So in that we see first one, that is the type expression. So before moving on to the type expression, I will explain what are the application of the types. So how, what is the type handling, what is the need of the type handling and the compilers. First one, as you also already know, that is called type checking. What do you mean by type checking? That is, type checking ensures that whether logical rules applied by your program is correct during the runtime. Whether if it is correct when you provide an expression or when you provide a condition, whether that operator is working as such, that is correct. Okay, so whether its behavior is correct, whether operator or whether a loop is behavior is correct, or it matches with the rules of the compiler, that is checked by what? Type checking. Okay, for example, when you use a return, it must return a value. So if it does not return a value, that's an error. So that type checking, that is the first and preliminary application of the types, that is called type checking. It's very important tools for the compiler. Next one is the translation application, and the translation application, as you all know, it is an explicit conversion is done during the translation application. For example, if I am converting a float to int, I am converting. So when I am converting float to int, the truncation of data happens because float has decimal point but int has no decimal point. So that is handled by the translation application. It is also done in the runtime. Also relative addresses, pointers and arrays, we only get the first address and next address is calculated by the compiler with the offset. That is also handled by what? Types. Okay. Next, we move to the type expression. Before moving to the type expression, I will say what is the definition of the type expression. What do you mean by type expression? For example, a type. Type means what? For example, integer. Integer has a structure. That structure is defined by what? Type expression. So, what do you mean by a type expression? If every type has a structure, that structure is defined by what? Type expression. So type expression can be a basic type or a user defined type. How we can build user defined type? We can build user defined type from what? Basic type. From the basic type, we are applying operators. That operator is called constructors in compiler basics. So it can be a basic type like integer, float, etc., or it can be a user defined type, that is, for example, array. How we are building array? Array can be built from the basic type plus indexes are we building, isn't it? For example, I will show a figure. For example, this is the type expression for int. So here, first one is the basic type. This is a type expression. So int type expression is called what? Integer. So from the integer, I am applying an operator. That operator is called array. This is called operator. This operator is called constructor. That is type constructor in the compiler terminology. It is called, the operator is called type constructor. From the basic type, we are applying an operator. That operator is called type constructors in the terminology of the compiler. So that we are applying operator, which operator we are applying? Array, and then we get what? Index 3, and again we apply array. If one index, only one array, one operator to be applied. Here two indexes, so two times we have to apply the operator. This is a simple example for the type expression in Q3. So this is what a type expression. Okay. So the type expression for this is, that is here the type is int 2 or 3. So that's what you mean by this figure. What the information we get from this figure? We are constructing an integer type. That is, constructing an integer type. The for example, integer type array with index 2, 3. So the type expression for this can be written as array 2, array 3, is the type expression. Okay, so first one I apply array and with the 2 index, and then again I apply the type constructor, that is 3, then 2 integers. So I am delivering the meaning from the top to bottom. So I explain it from the top to bottom. So simply we can say the array, that is an array of 2 rows and 3 columns, that is an array of 2 arrays with 3 integers. That is 2 arrays. 2 rows means we are defining what 2 arrays. This is the first array, this is the second array with 3 integers. Is it? Again explain once again. So this is int 3. So I can say either wise, that is here 2 rows is we are declaring. Declaring 2 rows means this is the first array, this is the second array with 3 columns means 3 integers. So 2 arrays with 3 integer value, that is why I have written array 2, again I am declaring 2 arrays with what? 3 integers. Okay, so this is defined by what type expression? So type expression says how the, what is the type of that what is the type, or sorry, what is the structure of the type is defined by the type expression. Simply 2, 3, that is what you have understood and see, that is correct. But when we are defining, it's more broader sense we are defining. That is integer 2, 3 means what? 2 rows and 3 columns, that is 2 arrays with 3 values. That's it. So from here I am drawing the type expression, that is integer, that is 2. 2 rows means I am declaring first array with 2 rows, then I am declaring array with, and then I partition that array with 3 columns. That's value is called what? Integer. This array 2 rows, then again I am applying the operator called array, then so we have discussed definition of type expression. Next one, what are the different types of expression? That is basic type. Every basic type, integer, float, etc. is a type expression. Next one, a type name is type expression. Earlier we have seen integer for what? Integer. So that integer is also a type expression. Next one, type expression can be formed by applying what? Array. We can apply a constructor to a type, that is also what a type expression we have seen early. Next one, record. Record means what? DBMS in tuples of data, recordical data, that is symbol table. In tuples you have seen symbol table, that is also, that's field, and that can be formed by using fields and field name and their types. That is also what a type expression. Next one, very important, is not abstract versus these. Okay, so if we are converting a float to int, float has been converted to what? Int. Converted to int. So float is s and int is t. So float as converted to int, I can give yes gives 1 t. Float has been converted to int, so yes gives 1 t. That is function from type s to type t. S from function yes, I am converting to what type? That is function types. That is type conversion we are using. Next one, s and t are the type expression. Its cross product is also a type expression, but that cross product, for example, cross product is mainly defined in the terms of function parameters argument, and we also says that Cartesian product is higher precedence than what? That is function giving us this t. That's that has lower precedence than what? Also, we can say a is equal to 3.14. That is 3.14. The value of the variables is also what type expression? Yep, that's about it. That is basic type is a type expression. Type name is a type expression. Type expression can be formed by applying operators called array. Also, record data structures. By applying record type constructor. Earlier we have applied array type constructor for array and record type constructor for record. And next one, type expression for by using type constructors of function type. For when we are converting explicit conversion, in the case of both case of functions also, when arguments is converted from int to float, that can be also applied. Also explicit type conversions, as I say in this example. And also Cartesian product is also a type expression, and also type expression whose values is called constant values is also called what type expression. That's about a general introduction about the types, and we have discussed what you mean by type expression, what are the different type expressions. So that's about till now. Understand the concept thoroughly. Then only you can move into the details of the types and type expressions. Next we see the type equivalence in the next video. So understand thoroughly. Okay.